नमस्कार एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टुडेज वीडियो। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न दैट हाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट एबिटा EBITDA एबिटा ऑफ एनी कंपनी यू वांट। सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट हियर इज एबिटा term EBITDA tells us many story that is hidden here. So we will be learning ki how to calculate EBITDA all by yourself, what is the significance of calculating EBITDA of any company, and how you can calculate it all by yourself without going to any website, without following anything, just all by yourself you can calculate EBITDA all by yourself. So what is this EBITDA? This is earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization. So as you can see that this is a quarterly result of JSW Steel Limited. See what it is written here: statement of unaudited consolidated financial results for the quarter and 9 months ended 31st December 2021. So as you guys must have understood, this is the consolidated financial result of JSW Steels for the quarter. For the quarter, this one means this is the third quarter of FY22 and 9 months ended. So from this actual data, we are going to calculate EBITDA. So as you, most of you like have heard of EBITDA and you guys have a brief idea of what is EBITDA, but like what are the ways we can actually calculate EBITDA? Is that we can calculate EBITDA from this place, revenue from operations. From here you can calculate EBITDA, total revenue from operations. From here you can calculate EBITDA by deducting expenses like cost of material consumed, purchase of stock in trade, changes in inventories, mining premium, employees benefit expense, power and fuel cost, other expense. So if you deduct all these figures from this figure, this figure, total revenue from operations, you will get what is EBITDA for this company. Means you have to consider this figure. Also you guys must know that EBITDA means operating income of the company. So what does it mean by operating income? That means company has revenue from operations. Means what do they do? See, in this case this is a steel company, JSW Steel Limited. So this is a steel company. So what is their main operation? It is production of steel, right? They produce steel. So let us go to their press release and find out by ourselves what do they actually do. This is JSW Steel's, you can say, financial performance for third quarter FY21 and 22. This is a press release. On which date they released these informations on press? 21st of January 2022. So what is their work on standalone basis? They produce crude steel. See, crude steel production of 4.41 million tons. Sellable steel sales. So they produce steel and sell steel, right? So how do they produce steel? From iron ore, through various processes, they produce crude steel and then they sell it. So revenue from operations, you can see it is given here, quarterly operating EBITDA. That means this is this quarter's, means Q3 FY22's EBITDA of 6797 crores, and this is standalone. And quarterly net profit after tax, you can see, is this. So in this video we are only going to calculate EBITDA. So for now let us ignore all other things, net profit and all. Let us just concentrate on what is EBITDA, how to calculate EBITDA. So as you can see, crude steel production on consolidated basis is 5.21 million tons and in standalone it was 4.41. Sellable steel was 4.00 million tons and sellable steel console is 4.63. Now why you should consider this standalone and consolidated? See the difference between these numbers. It is very small, right? On standalone basis means from their core business they earned, produced this much amount of steel in this quarter and they sold this much 4 million tons of steel in this quarter. But on standalone basis means including their standalone means their core business plus their holding companies, their subsidiaries, their joint ventures, putting it all together they produced 5.21 million tons of steel and they sold 4.63 million tons of steel. And what is the difference between their revenues from operation? It is around, as you can see, almost around 10,000 crore rupees of differences. So there is a difference between quarterly operating EBITDA, which on console basis is 9132 and on standalone basis it is 6797. So it is already given here, right, in the press release. Then why should we even be bothered about how to calculate EBITDA as it is given here? So why should we once again calculate it? You must understand, see, while you will be working in a company as an equity research analyst, at that time you may not have so much of liberty to get all these figures at once. So you as an analyst, you should be able to understand how they have actually calculated, what are the figures they have included. It is given there, everybody knows that EBITDA is given there, and on any news channel also you can get those EBITDAs. But if you know how this EBITDA has arrived to this number, what is the actual story behind this, what is the amount of interest which is not included in this number, what is the tax amount, what is the depreciation and amortization amount, if you guys want to know, if you guys really want to know how their operations has performed, in that case I recommend you guys to calculate EBITDA all by yourself. So in this video we are going to calculate EBITDA of JSW Steels on consolidated basis as well as on standalone basis. So first we are starting with calculation of EBITDA from total revenue from operations. So how to calculate? Let us take a look. Just open an Excel sheet or just have your calculator ready. I think now my screen is visible to all of you. So let's go to this. So this is 31071. So what we can do is, there is a 38071. This is their total revenue from operations. Total revenue from operations is this figure, right? So now what you are going to do is you are going to ignore this other income, right? Because this is earning before interest, tax and depreciation, and also we refer to EBITDA as operating income. As the term operating income suggests that you should only include income from operations and not other income. What is other income? We will be discussing about it later on in our next video. So we will be considering only total revenue from operations. Just focus on this term, operations, total revenue. Okay, gross sales plus other operating income. So if you add these two figures you will get to this number. So we have put that on our Excel sheet. Now let us consider these expenses. So for the production of steel, see, total revenue from operations, so in order to incur this amount of sales, what expenses that you have made in this period? Cost of material consumed means for the production of steel you had to buy iron ore, you had to buy limestones, you had to buy many other things which are required to produce steel. So cost of materials consumed means the raw material that you have consumed in order to produce and sell the steel. So this is 17,793 cost of material consumed. Now let us come to the next term, which is purchase of stock in trade. So purchase of stock in trade. Purchase of stock in trade. This figure is 158 crores. Then you can see there is one figure, changes in inventories of finished goods work in progress. Changes in inventories, finished goods, work in progress. This is negative 1559. Negative 1559. Mining premiums and royalties. This company has mines. So either they can have their own captive mines from where they will procure their raw materials, or they can take mines on lease. Means this mine is not completely owned by them, but they have taken lease. So mining premium and royalties, this is their expense. 3047. 3047. What is this? Mining premium. And then see employees benefit expenses. So now what is employee benefit expenses? It can include many other components other than salary as well, but for now only we are just considering employee benefit expense as only salary. So this is 966 crores. Salary 966 crores. Then there is finance cost. So do you think that we are going to consider this finance cost in calculation of EBITDA? No, we are not going to include finance cost. That also means interest. We are not going to include interest amount in our calculation. Why? Because we are going to calculate here what? Earnings before interest. Earning before interest. We are going to calculate earning before interest. So that means, as we are going to calculate earnings of the company before paying interest, so we won't consider finance cost in the calculation of EBITDA. Is that clear to all of you? So we won't consider finance cost in our calculation of EBITDA. So this is interest. Interest means finance cost, depreciation and amortization. See, earnings before interest, tax, depreciation, amortization. So we are not considering this depreciation and amortization either, because this is non-cash expenditure. So why this is not considered here, and why finance cost is also not considered here in the calculation? We all know that it is a formula, right? But has this formula arrived only because somebody came up with this theory or formula? No. The reason is that suppose you want to compare two or more firms with this particular company, JSW Steel. So while you are comparing more than two firms in a sector, so you have to ignore what is their depreciation, what is their finance cost, means what is their capital structure, how much they have debt on their balance sheet, how much equity they have. You avoid these things for the calculation so that you have a fair understanding of businesses' operating performance. Some may have more debt on their balance sheet, some may have more old assets, and there may be more depreciation upon that. So for the time being only, we are ignoring these figures from our calculation of EBITDA. Suppose you have JSW Steel and you have JSPL Jindal Steel and Power. Now JSW Steel made a capex of 45,000 crores. So it is huge, right? And in order to finance that big amount of capex, they incurred debt as well as they used their equity funding. So if you compare these figures with Jindal Steel and Power's figure, so it is not fair to compare these two companies, because their JSW Steel's production capacity is only around 10 to 12 million tons, and Jindal Steel and Power's JSW Steel's production capacity is around 35 million tons. They have production capacity of 25 for JSW Steel. So it is a huge company. For JSPL, their production capacity is only 10 million tons. So you guys can easily understand that JSW Steel is a huge company, at least 2.5 times larger than JSPL, right? So JSW Steel also has capability, they have the capacity to get more debt from the market, get more equity funding from the market, and they have also greater disbursement surplus. So what is the capital structure, how they can spend in order to start one project? If you compare this thing with these small companies, it is not fair, right? They have more capacity to invest, so definitely their finance cost will also increase, and JSPL has less capacity to invest, so their finance cost will remain low, right? Same depreciation and amortization. So they have, JSW Steel has more assets, so they will incur more depreciation compared to Jindal Steel and JSPL, who has less assets. So these two things should not be there in the calculation of EBITDA, so that we can have a fair comparison between these two companies, which are not of same size, but we can compare their operational efficiencies and performance by the calculation of EBITDA margin. So what is EBITDA margin? EBITDA margin is EBITDA divided by this total revenue from operations. If you do this, you will get your EBITDA margin. So this is also very important, and after calculation of EBITDA margin, you can actually compare these two companies. Although this company is so small, its production capacity is 10 million tons and its production capacity is 25 million tons, so it was nowhere comparable, right? They definitely have more net profit. JSW Steel has greater net profit, greater revenues, much more expenses than JSPL. And JSPL, as it is a small company, so their revenue is less, so their profit is also less, and their expenses is also less. So if you find out that JSW Steel's EBITDA is, let's say, 9,000 crores, and for JSPL, you may find that JSPL's EBITDA is around 3,000 crores. So if you just look at it with a layman's perspective, you will think JSW Steel is a better company than JSPL. Why? Because it has more EBITDA than JSPL. But is it so? Just think about it. Is it really the real picture? No. Why? Because it is a large company, so it has more EBITDA. It is a small company, so it has small EBITDA. Okay, lesser amount of EBITDA. But if you calculate EBITDA by total revenue from operations, then you will arrive at EBITDA margin. EBITDA margin means their operating profit margin. So if suppose you find out that JSW Steel's operating margin, operating margin means their EBITDA margin is, let's say, 25%, and if you find out that JSPL's operating margin is, let's say, 30%, then you guys tell me which company is operating more efficiently. Definitely you will come up with ki JSPL is performing more efficiently than JSW Steel. Although it is a small company, but they are operating very efficiently, and this is a large company. In spite of that, they are not been able to operate that efficiently, right? So for that, we are ignoring this depreciation, amortization, interest from here because of the capital structure thing, and of the they have more assets. So for these things, we are excluding those things, and these are non-cash items, right? This is a non-cash expenditure, and it depends completely on your capital structure. So capital structure, see, JSW Steel can invest their own reserves in order to open one plant, right? And they can take debt as well. So they have either their own equity funding or debt funding. Suppose this is a plant. So how they can establish a plant is they can take either equity funding or they can take debt funding. Right? So what is their capital structure, position of capital structure? We are not considering it here. We are ignoring that, and also we are ignoring this non-cash expenditures in order to calculate EBITDA, and we are directly calculating EBITDA, then we are also calculating EBITDA margin. So we are just trying to figure out what is their operational performance. So now let us take a look at this. So we have ignored finance cost and depreciation amortization expenses. As you have seen, this is salary, means employee benefit expenses. Power and fuel, you have to consider this one, and it is 3311 crores. Power and fuel and other expenses, it is 5223. So now what we are going to do is we are going to calculate EBITDA. We are going to calculate EBITDA of this company. So how do you calculate EBITDA is you press equal to, then you go to this total revenue from operations, TRFO, total revenue from operations, minus you deduct cost of material consumed, minus you deduct POST, means this is your purchase of stock in trade, then you minus this figure, that is your changes in inventories of finished goods, work in progress and stock in trade. So this figure is a negative, right? So when you put negative along with negative, means what I am trying to say is this figure minus this figure. So this is minus minus plus. Anyway, so we are just putting the minus sign over here for now. Minus MP is mining premium. Minus we are doing SAL, means salary, means employee benefit expenses, minus we are doing power and fuel, minus we are doing operating expenses. Press enter. You will arrive at, this is the EBITDA on console basis. This is console basis EBITDA. So now how come I am so sure that my calculation of EBITDA is 100% perfect? So it is given here. See, this is their consolidated number, quarterly operating EBITDA, 9132 crore. So in our calculation, see, it is 9132 crore EBITDA. Now we are going to calculate EBITDA percent. Means what is their operating profit margin or EBITDA margin, which is popularly known as EBITDA margin. So how do you calculate is EBITDA divided by your turnover, total turnover from operations. Press enter. So into 100, this is 23.98%. Let us find out if it is given anywhere so that I can show it to you. Console basis is 23.98. Subsidiary is 9 function is not working on my PDF. It's okay. See, this is the EBITDA with EBITDA margin. So what is written that the company registered quarterly revenue from operations, this amount 38071. So 38071 is consolidated turnover. There are consolidated total revenue from operations on console basis, and their EBITDA is 9132 crores. EBITDA percent is 23.98. So this is approx 24%. With an EBITDA margin of 24%. So this is your EBITDA margin. Now let us also try to find out standalone numbers. Now how to calculate standalone number? It is also very simple, same as this calculation, exact same. Statement of unaudited standalone financial results for the quarter and 9 months ended 31st December 2021. So this is the quarter ended number you can see. You can just consider this number. So just you do the calculation on your calculator and just see it. This is your total revenue from operations. Don't consider other income. It is other income won't be included here. So total revenue from operations, you have considered this on your calculator. You type 28,850 minus you do cost of material consumed. So this is minus 28,850 minus, you are considering this figure, right? Minus you do this figure, that is cost of material consumed 14051, minus you also do 1205 minus. So minus minus it becomes plus, right? So what you are actually doing is you are actually doing minus to all these figures, not this one. This one won't be considered as this is employee benefit. No, sorry, this is finance cost. This is finance cost. This is depreciation and amortization. We won't consider this one as well. Power and fuel, we have to eliminate. Other expense, we have to eliminate. So minus 3 you have done, plus minus means minus 1205 you have done. Now minus 4, sorry, minus 3047 you do, minus 498 you have to do, minus 2441 you have to do, minus 3218 you have to do. Then you will arrive at this figure. Standalone EBITDA 6797. So just do the calculation, and my calculation is also exact same. 6797. This is your EBITDA. Earnings before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization. So EBITDA, now you divide it by total revenue from operations. This is 28,850. So when you do it, what you get is divided by 28,850 into, you do 100, because you want to understand what is the EBITDA percent, right? So you multiply it with 100. So what you get is 23.559 you get, right? Is this concept clear? EBITDA by total revenue from operations. This is your result. This is your EBIT percentage. EBITDA percentage, that means it is your operating percent, operating margin on standalone basis. Now check this, whether it is correct or not. So you have to just scroll down. And see, the EBITDA margin is correct. EBITDA of 6797. EBITDA of 6797. This is your total turnover from operations. And this is your EBITDA margin, 23.559. So 59 means this is 6. So 23.56. So if they have considered it 23.6. Correct? You can also write it as 23.6, because this is 59 plus, just if you increase 59, just increase 1, this is 60. So 6, so 59.56. So 56 as, so in order to make it round off, they have made it this one. Now as we do not have the exact figure, because this is 28,850 crores and there is actually 7 zeros over here. 1 crore means 1, after that 7 zero. So this 7 digit is missing here, na? Here also in EBITDA, this 7 digit is missing here. So if you actually calculate it with that long figure, then you will get to this number exactly. So this is what EBITDA is. This is how you can calculate operating profit margin of any company. So in our next videos, we will be discussing what is PBT, profit before tax margin, PBT margin and PAT margin. And okay, let us just go through this thing once again, because I have something more, another thing which is really interesting regarding this calculation of EBITDA. I think you guys should also learn that as well. So this time we calculated EBITDA from this figure, total revenue from operations. From here, this we calculated. Now you can actually arrive to this EBITDA by doing back calculation. So for that, what figure you should consider? Tell me. This is the figure given here, right? Let us go to a clean page. Or okay, let me just erase these things. All this dirt. Okay, now take a look at this. So you are getting profit before share of profit or loss of joint venture. So this is consolidated numbers. So see, suppose you have only net profit for the period or year ended this one. So from how you can calculate EBITDA from net profit? This is your net profit given. So from here, how can you calculate EBITDA? Any idea? So as it is said, EBITDA. Just follow this formula. EBITDA. So just follow these terms. So here you are left with this figure, net profit for the period or year ended 4516. So if you add back this total tax expenses, as this has been eliminated earlier from this figure, so if you add back this figure, means what I am trying to say is, if you just add 4516 and if you add 1745, you will get to 6261, which is profit before tax. Profit before tax minus total tax expenses is your profit after tax or profit for the period. So if you add back your tax amount which was deducted from profit before tax, you will get to profit before tax. So profit after tax or profit for the period plus the total tax expenses, you will get to profit before tax. So your tax component in EBITDA calculation is done. So you are arriving at this figure. There is no exceptional items. So this figure is your profit before exceptional items and tax. Now there is one thing written here. You can see share of profit or loss of joint ventures. As this is a consolidated number, consolidated financial statement, so there you can see that share of profit company has received or loss company have received of joint ventures. So this is 22 crores. So this is also part of your company's activity. So you can just add it back. So add 22 with this figure. So this was profit, right? So if you want to go back, as you are back calculating it, then you have to do minus this. Why we are doing minus? See, 6261, you had profit before exceptional item and tax. So you incurred a small profit here, right? It is profit. So this is why this is in positive. If it was loss, then it would have been in negative, because you are adding it, right? If you just add 6239 plus 22 crores, see, 9 plus 2, 11, 1, you have 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 2, 5, 6, 2, 6. So this 22 figure has been added to this. So if you want to go back on your calculation, so you have to eliminate this. So 6261 minus you do 22. So you will arrive at this figure, which is profit before share of profit or loss of joint ventures, 6239. So from here, what you can do is simply this figure has been deducted, right? These two figures, finance cost and depreciation expense and amortization expenses, is included in this figure. So you have to add back, as what I am trying to say is, from your total revenue from operations, all these expenses were deducted, and this is total expense. Total expense consists of what? 4. This is serial number 4. So this entire figure, after doing add less, whatever material items are given here, so after considering all this, the total expenses comes to be, see, this is expenses and these are the all expenses, A to I. So this is 4. So it consists of total expense. Total expense is this. So means this figure also includes the figure for finance cost as well as figure for depreciation and amortization. Now, as we know that for the calculation of EBITDA, we do not consider depreciation and amortization. We also exclude finance cost. So we have to exclude these two figures from this figure. So how do you do it is, this figure has arrived. This figure has arrived how? By doing this figure minus this figure. You can see 3 minus 4 is equal to 5, right? So that means 3 is this one, total income. Total income means total revenue from operations plus other income is your total income. 1 plus 2. Are you guys understanding? So you guys must notice that there is one other income included here, but we consider this one only, right? So yes, we will be deducting this one as well. After we deduct these things, finance cost and depreciation and amortization expenses. So what we have to do is, 6239 is given here. You have got 6239. So you can add back 31986. So you will arrive at 38225. Now you deduct 17 this finance cost 1764. You also deduct 3311 from this figure, and you will arrive at 33150. But we are not really looking at it, right? We just want to calculate EBITDA. So just skip it, 6239. Okay. Now add back only these two figures, because these two figures has been eliminated from this total revenue figure. What I am trying to say is that we have to eliminate these three numbers from this calculation. Why? Because this is your profit before share of profit. ठीक है? And this is your total expense. In total expenses, finance cost is also included here, and depreciation means interest and depreciation is included in this total expenses. So after deduction of all these items, you have arrived to this number. So you just have to add back this number and this number. So you just add back 1764. You just add back 3311. Yeah, this is finance cost, right? Yeah, this is finance cost. So not 3311, sorry about that. 6239, you add back 1764, plus you add back 1283, you will arrive at 9286. Okay? From 9286, you deduct 154, because this other income, which should not become a part of EBITDA, it is included here and it has inflated this figure, but we are not considering this total figure. And this number has arrived how? This number has arrived from, this is A, this is B, this total figures I am saying. This total figures I am saying, just look at it. So A has arrived from this plus this 154. So we don't need this 154, so you eliminate this. So then if you eliminate 154 from this A figure, you will arrive to this figure. And this is what we are looking for, total revenue from operations. This is B figure, means total subtotal of this. So A minus B is actually this. So you are adding back these two figures which were unnecessarily deducted from the figures. These two were unnecessarily deducted, so you are adding it back. It was unnecessarily added, so you are eliminating it, and you are arriving at our EBITDA of 9132. So these two are the process of how you can calculate EBITDA. You can calculate EBITDA from revenue from operations, that is gross sales plus other operating income. So total operating revenue from total revenue from operations, from here also you can calculate EBITDA and then find out what is EBITDA percent, means operating profit margin. So what you do is this divided by total revenue from operations and you get your operating margin. Operating margin or EBITDA margin. Okay. So I think this is very simple now. You guys will be able to calculate EBITDA from total revenue from operations going this way down, or you can calculate EBITDA from profit after tax. This is your profit after tax, PAT. This is net profit for the period ended. It also means profit after tax. So from PAT, how you can arrive to EBITDA, and from total operating revenue, how you can arrive to EBITDA, and also how you can calculate EBITDA percent by just dividing EBITDA with total operating revenue. You guys have learned this in this video. So I hope that this video was informative for you. And why do we really need to calculate EBITDA and EBITDA margin? I think you guys have understood. Now suppose if you have any doubt regarding this video, and if you have any questions related to any other topic, you can just comment down below. And all our students, all our interns who are working with us and who are getting trained from us, if you guys have any doubt, you can just ping me on my personal WhatsApp number. All the very best. Namaskar all. Goodbye.